Pittsburgh on this glorious frosty Sunday morning. So glad you all made it here safely today. I don't think, is it slick out there? Was it? Didn't see too slick when I got here. Good. Well, today we're continuing with the sermon series, Kansas Dreaming. We'll do some more dreaming today. And next Sunday, during the second service, we're going to install our officers. So if you're an officer and you'd like to be, formally installed, come to the second service. But just trust that you are installed, whether you're there or not. I'll do a remote installation in my office before the service. Just going to the games. Anyways, you're good. You're covered. Game day was Saturday, and we're going to do it on Tuesday.
Three o'clock
on Tuesday. And then there's choir practice at 6:30 on Wednesday, bells at 5:30 on Thursday. Praise band practice at 7. See you guys there. You all can come too if you want to. It's pretty fun. I mean, I have fun. You guys have fun? It's fun for me. I enjoy it. We need tambourine players. Yeah. And you guys
nominate Betty.
What?
I'm going to nominate Betty.
Probably a lot of ska fans out here too, right? A lot of people like ska. They usually have a guy who kind of dances around during the, you do that too. If you don't know what that is, Google Mighty Mighty Basta and watch some videos. Anyways, what else is going on? Dolores Diner, Thursday night, January 20th. Group 2 is serving. And then our lunch bunch is going to the Eastside Cafe on Thursday, the 20th. It's very important to sign up or let Marcia know. Otherwise, who is going so she can arrange transportation? There are difficulties with the current bus. So, take a little more effort than usual to do the logistics there. All right, we have raised $2,106 for the Dawson Springs tornado relief effort. I'm going to get that check in the mail tomorrow. So thank you all for contributing. It's been, it's been kind of bittersweet. I've been watching friends from there on Facebook rebuild homes. Somebody just posted a picture of her foundation yesterday. So that's really starting over, and a lot of people are doing that there. Anything else going on? Anything else to announce? Any joys? Concerns? Prayer concerns? All right. Let's worship our loving Almighty God, God of our freedom, Please pray with me. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we are blessed to be your people. We are blessed to know your love, your peace, your salvation. We are blessed to be here today in your house with our brothers and sisters in Christ, and we pray that your Spirit be with us, fill us, Lord. Keep us filled with your Spirit. Lord, we need your help. This nation needs your help. The whole world needs your help to see each other differently than we do now. To look past what we perceive as our differences, some things even seem insurmountable. We might believe there are people that you just can't get through them. You just can't talk to them. They're never going to change. We're always going to be at odds. Lord, show us a way through. Help us to not give up, to reach for what seems unattainable, to dream of the impossible. Because we know if it is your will, it will be made possible. Help us to be part of your will, to be part of this work of global reconciliation. I'm so bored. We're dealing with a pandemic the likes of which the planet hasn't seen in a century. We pray for healing. We pray for your blessing on all, everyone, especially our men and women in the medical profession who are inundated at this time, and also our schools here in Pittsburg are closed the latter part of this week. We pray that children and the classes, everyone come together, back into the school buildings very soon, safely. It's a difficult time, and it just seems to be going on and on and on. But we need your strength, Lord, to get through this. Even though it may not be at the top of our minds all the time, it's kind of a nagging thing at the back of our minds. Especially as we hear every mercy on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon. But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, send her away. She keeps shouting after us. He answered, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But she came and knelt before him, saying, Lord, help me. He answered, it is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs. She said, yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered her, woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish. And her daughter was healed instantly. The word of the Lord. Jesus said, what? How could our loving Lord and Savior Jesus Christ call people dogs? Ugh. Now, I've read commentaries that try to make this more palatable. For example, several biblical commentators have written that the Greek word interpreted here in English as dogs really ought to be puppies or house pets. And it's as if to say that everyone who is not a son or daughter of Abraham, they're all just adorable little doggies. Who could be offended by that? Everybody. I have a puppy at home, if you hadn't heard. And my family and I have to tell him repeatedly, this is not your food, this is my food. My doggy. However, occasionally, when he's following me around while I'm eating something, because I found a lot of times it's easier to stand up than sit down because he'll be right on me, I will accidentally drop something on the floor. I can't resist it. He looks up at me with those little brown eyes, and I can just telepathically hear him say, please, please. I mean, not really, but I mean, this. I can't help it, because great is his faith in what a softy I am. So, nobody wants to be called a house pet, or a puppy, or a dog. Except, well, the dog, the bounty hunter. And there are guys who call each other dog. And I want to tell you a really awesome dad joke. Tell somebody, what you need is some up dog. And hopefully they'll ask you, what's up dog? You say, not much, what's up with you? Welcome. You are so welcome. Generally, people don't like to be treated like, they don't like to be called dogs. They don't like to be treated like dogs or animals. That is, that they are worth less than everybody else. That they are less than human beings. People don't like to be treated as if they ought not be afforded the rights and privileges of other people. Did you know that the American Civil War, in a sense, began here in the great state of Kansas? Yeah? Well, Kansas, it was actually a territory at the time. It was on the brink of statehood. It's really close. And fortunately, the majority of Kansans believed, and they voted this way, that enslaving human beings was wrong. Treating human beings like animals is wrong and would not be tolerated in the great state of Kansas. Thank God. So, pro-slavers took up arms against the free staters. So the question whether Kansas would enter the Union as a slave state was of national importance. It wasn't just a Kansas thing. This affected the whole nation because Kansas' two senators would tip the balance of power in the Senate, in the Congress, which was bitterly divided over the issue of slavery. Kansas was finally admitted into the Union as a free state the same day enough Southern senators left to allow the statehood to pass. crisis, which led to
the Civil War.
And thinking about all that, thinking that there were people willing to kill for the right to own human beings, and that it led to a war that killed over 700,000 people. And even today, there are people proposing sorts of civil wars, a sort of civil war in our nation, because they see our nation as too full of people who are different from them, aren't like them, who don't think like they do or look like they do. I tell you honestly, it makes me wish I had some updog. But I tell you, no matter how dark the days may seem, I have a dream. I've dreamed that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day, out in the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even in the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of oppression, that it will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four children will one day live in a nation where they will be judged by not by the color of their skin, but by their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day down in Alabama, with its vicious races, with its governor having his lips dripping with words of interposition and nullification, that one day right down in Alabama, black boys and black girls would join hands with white girls and white boys and as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be engulfed, every hill shall be exalted, every mountain shall be made low, the rough places made a plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all flesh will see it together. Okay, I borrowed that dream from Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. Yesterday was his birthday. And I also had that same dream for the whole country. Same dream. Even though we seem to be drifting farther and farther away from that dream at the moment, I still believe it can come true because I believe that God loves everyone. He loves all people. And I am from the great state of Kansas, where our aspiration is to reach the unattainable and our dream is the realization of the impossible. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I believe this dream can come true because I have faith that people can learn, just like our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ did in our scripture today. Yes, it sounds impossible, but it's true. Our perfect, sinless, fully human, fully divine Lord and Savior Jesus Christ learned something. Remember, we heard him state his mission. I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. It makes sense. He's the Hebrew Messiah. What else was he going to do? And there are only so many hours in the day, and you have to start with the target demographic. That's just management 101. But then this Canaanite woman comes along, a Canaanite woman, a member of one of God's people's enemies, who obviously had great faith in the Hebrew God and his Messiah. And so it became obvious to our Lord right then and there that it was time to go global. Jesus learned that God's kingdom and his mission to enact that kingdom is bigger than he had initially imagined, and that it was more encompassing than he had first dreamed. And I have another dream today, that with so many in this world who are so passionate about deepening the divides between us, that all people of the world, all the peoples, would become
even more passionate about humanity growing together for the good of all people. And I hope we will dream this dream together. I hope we will pray for it together. I hope we will work for it together. And I hope we will learn from it together. Amen. Would like to become a member of this congregation, we ask that you come forward after our invitation. Dreams coming true. Table of our Lord.
that was the original tourist trap. They had these guys figured out. They sold pieces of the cross to the crusaders. Real live piece of Jesus' cross right here. People actually fell for that. And I can't remember, they collected these pieces of the cross from the crusaders. And it was like, 2 miles long and a mile wide, at the crossbar. So it's huge, huge, huge thing. It wasn't Jesus Christ, it's impossible. But people kind of lose their sense of time, how many centuries had gone by. It seemed like it happened yesterday, but that was centuries ago. Anyways, so this table actually is, even though it appears to be 12, I don't know, is that 4 foot by 2? So it actually stretches around the world. This table is all over the world. People all over the world come to this table. Same thing. All our brothers and sisters in Christ all over the world, remembering our Savior, Jesus Christ, the same Savior. Same bread, same cup. That's a reason to hope right there. That there are so many people on planet Earth, I forget, over 2 billion, I think, that proclaim Jesus Christ. Lord, that's a reason to hope that we can come together. That's what started this denomination, was the idea that the Christian church on Earth, the church, is essentially one. Jesus Christ or not, we don't have anything against them. That's a potential brother or sister in Christ. That's, at the very least, it's someone to love. So it's good we come back to this table every week. Remember what Christ has done for us, and that we are not alone. We are not just a couple dozen or so people in a room. We are part of body, a global body. And everyone is welcome at this table, everybody. Anybody who has the desire to dine with Jesus Christ is welcome. For it was on the night when our Lord was betrayed that he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it. He said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Drink this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat this bread and drink the cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Please pray with me. Gracious and holy God, we give you thanks for this invitation to your Son's table. Dine with him and all of our brothers and sisters in Christ around the world. We pray, Lord, that your Spirit be with us. Help us to grow closer together in this church family, closer to our brothers and sisters in Christ and other congregations here and around the world, and reach out to those who have never dined at this table. Or have at one time, but for one reason or another haven't come back. Maybe they haven't been invited back. Help us to see, Lord. Help us to see those who are with us and those who aren't. And see them all as people, as human beings you love. We ask your blessing upon these elements, Lord, upon the bread. We ask this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. And we have 3 offering and communion stations, one here and one at each exit. Now hear the benediction. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, keep us filled with your Holy Spirit. Give us strength. Courage and guidance, everything we need to love others healed